The Maple Leafs 2 and the Montreal Canadiens 1 at the end of one period. Napier opened the scoring for Montreal at 2:48, and the Leafs came back in a power play. Darryl Sittler's third of the playoffs at 5:06, and Lanny McDonald put Toronto ahead with his third playoff goal, his third in this series, at 8:14. Toronto 2 and the Canadiens 1. Montreal outshot Toronto 13-7. Howie Meeker, there's some psychological impact, I think, at work in this series. The Leafs, under Coach Roger Neilson, have never beaten the Canadiens. And I wonder just how much of an effect this might be having on the Leafs. There is the feeling that if they could get one win, this could be a much more interesting series than a lot of people think.
Dave, I don't think it should bother them here in Toronto. All right, maybe in Montreal, where the Canadiens always operate under a full head of steam. They're tough to beat anywhere, but particularly at the Montreal Forum, they always play so well. Here, I would think if they continue to skate the way they're doing, the defensemen are handling the puck better than any time in the series. They're not allowing the Canadiens to exert any pressure at all, and all you have to do is shoot the cotton picking puck at Dryden. And something's got to happen. If you get it at the net, get it at the net. And they got two goals because of it.
He said they're skating, and there had been the idea that they have to hit the Canadiens, slow them down to their speed. The other theory, and maybe the one we're seeing put into practice tonight, is to beat Montreal, you just have to try and outskate them no matter how fast they are.
That's right. And again, you have to get back into your own zone for a change. I think the Toronto Maple Leaf wingers are doing a heck of a job because they're forcing the Canadiens to shoot it in. And the defensemen are getting back there, getting the puck, getting turned around, and have it on the way out before the Canadian checkers can make contact with them. But Pommetier's the key. The little fellow stands up, plays like a trooper, got a chance.
And it's hardly a coincidence that the Leafs are ahead and Sittler and McDonald have scored the goals. There might not have been a way to notice a dispute after the McDonald goal, except that Bob Gainey got an unsportsmanlike conduct penalty. And if people are wondering, I think you might be able to tell them what he was complaining about.
Well, we want to take a look at this. It could have, might have been just a wee little bit offside. You'll see Salming and Burrows handle the puck. It's put back into the Leaf zone again very wisely. They're not running into the heavy traffic. They're controlling the puck deep in their own zone. Salming over to Burrows. Now watch the pass. Super pass right on the stick. But is he onside or offside? Back it up. Hey, topple roller again. Okay, let her go.
I guess the question is, when does he get the puck?
Yeah, I think it's tight. Yeah.
Or does that Montreal player in the middle of the ice touch the puck?
You'll see Dryden here come way out. He should have stopped the shot. Boy, McDonald really cranked up and let it go, but bad angle. Really a bad angle. He come out facing the puck and was off the angle just a little bit. Dryden normally would handle a shot like that, no trouble.
McDonald scores a few of them like that. Oh. No, there's probably nobody better in the league from that very position with that type of shot. I know that Lafleur and Bossy score more goals than McDonald does, but he seems to have a knack right from that position of putting the puck in the net. I think when we talk about Leafs' confidence and what a win might do for them, I think we saw an example of what coming from behind to take the lead might have done. They were ahead in Montreal in game number one, but there was always a feeling that the Canadiens hadn't started yet. Canadiens started tonight. They got the first goal. For the Leafs to come back, it just seemed to lift them in that first period. Now, whether it remains that way for the rest of the game, we'll have to find out.
Well, I think they're on a high, and they really have to win. The Toronto Maple Leaf fans have been super all winter long. They've played some wonderful hockey in here, and I don't think they're going to go out 4th Street. No way.
I don't know that we should be placing too much emphasis on that offside goal. The officiating is part of the game, and McDonald did score with a good shot. It's 2-1, and the Canadiens did kill the penalty by Gainey, which might have been a big call if the Leafs made it 3-1. Next, we'll have highlights of other series as Stanley Cup 79 continues in just a moment. Canadiens 3 and the Leafs 2 are in the second intermission at Maple Leaf Gardens. The Leafs, Howie Meeker, have played a pretty good game, but there's a two-minute span in the second period that stands as the reason they're behind, and that happens a lot against the Canadiens. You let down for a little bit, and you can be behind.
Well, you let down with these fellas, and the way they beat you is with their legs. Gosh, they're just a tremendous skating outfit, and you give them half a chance, they're going to put the puck in the net. The one really good thing is the Toronto Maple Leafs, after being down 3-2, came back and then made Dryden make about three or four big saves. They haven't quit, and they keep at it. They can get back in the game. We'd like to show you the Larry Robinson goal, and this is the second goal of the game. Napier's was exactly the same, where just by simply finishing the check, now skating into Robinson. Robinson's attempting to make a pass to Gainey. Can we stop it right there? either Turnbull or Sittler, all they had to do was just skate in, finish the check, tie up Big Robinson, nothing happens. Okay, away we go. The puck hits Turnbull, bounces free, Robinson goes in. Palmateer has really no chance at all because Salming's down in front of him and he can't make the move. But all you do in that type of goal is just take the man. Okay, here's the guy with the greatest wheels in the country. And spent the last 5 days at the Air Canada Midget Hockey Tournament in Winnipeg, and the kids said, hey, can those French Canadians boogie? And watch this guy boogie. Oh, around the outside. Burroughs finally runs him out of rink and hangs on. The puck gets into Lafleur's skate. Stay with him. He has one hand on the stick, throws it into the middle. Maloney has it. Lafleur comes up with it. Lapointe gets it. And watch Napier, another guy. Oh, right around the outside. And Palmateer, I don't know, makes a pretty good save. Takes the leg from under Napier. This is on exactly the same play. The play went right on from here over in the corner. Lemaire keeps the puck in. Now watch the Toronto Maple Leafs disappear in front of the net. Lemaire comes in. Look, nobody near him. Burrow leaves him wide open. No one comes back in to pick him up. Palmateer doesn't have a chance. You just can't leave men open in front of the net like that.
Robinson had all the time he wanted to score his, and Lemaire didn't need any time, nor did he want any. It's 3-2 Montreal at the end of two periods of play, live from Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto. You're watching the Stanley Cup playoffs.